In my video titled Extraterrestrial Civilizations and Why We Can't Detect Them, I calculated approximately as to what the number of planets in the observable universe is. So pretty much, there are 2 trillion galaxies in the observable universe. The average galaxy roughly has around 20 billion stars. And if there is at least a planet per star, which there very likely is, then by multiplying the average number of stars per galaxy with the number of galaxies, we get the number of stars and planets, because there is a planet per star. It has 22 zeros. Also, there are around 200 moons of planets in the solar system. So, it would also be very safe, likely a big underestimate, to say that there is a moon per planet on average in the universe. So there are also very likely at least 46 trillion moons. Now, in that video, I talked about what that number of planets specifically implies about the existence of alien civilizations. But here, I'm going to talk about what that number implies about what very weird planets, and also moons, likely exist. Because the number is so huge, we can get pretty specific with the properties of these planets and moons and describe a planet that actually does exist in the universe. Now, of course, that number of 46 trillion is just the number of planets and moons in the observable universe. Beyond the observable part, we don't really know certainly as to what is there. But very likely, at least the non-observable space that is close to the edge of the observable universe also has galaxies. And that relatively close, unobservable part could contain slightly more, or even many times more galaxies than the number of galaxies in the observable universe. So that would also mean that the total number of planets and moons in the entire universe is possibly even many times greater than the number of 46 trillion. If that is the case, we could get even more specific with the properties of a planet and a moon and describe something that actually exists. Now still, even with this number of 46 trillion in the observable universe, that means that there are so many combinations of traits of planets and moons that there exist planets and moons with some relatively specific traits, and there are likely many of them. But the more specific we get with the traits, the number of planets with those traits obviously starts to drop. We can describe very few specific traits of planets and moons, such as tall mountains and huge canyons. The tallest planetary mountain in the solar system is on Mars, and that is Olympus Mons, at 21 kilometers in height. And the largest canyon in the solar system is also on Mars, that is Valles Marineris. It is around 3,500 kilometers long, about 300 kilometers wide, and about 4 kilometers deep. Now, outside of the solar system, there certainly is a mountain of whatever origin on a planet that is around double the height of Olympus Mons. That's right, there are almost certainly out there 40 kilometer tall mountains on some planets, and likely on a pretty big number of planets in total. Maybe there is even a planet with a 50 kilometer tall mountain. And there's also likely a planet with a canyon that is twice as long as Valles Marineris, twice as wide, twice as deep, and possibly there is even a one which is 4 times the length. So there's a big possibility that there is a canyon on some planet that is as long as the diameter of Earth. Let's move on to other traits. The likelihood of a planet existing that has oceans of water on its surface and a relatively thick atmosphere, which is a must if it has oceans of water, such as Earth, is extremely likely. Although we can't see examples of such planets in the solar system besides Earth currently, there are some indications that such a water ocean existed in the past, also on Mars, when it had a much thicker atmosphere. Connected to the huge Valles Marineris Canyon, there are channels that indicate a water flow. There are other pieces of evidence as well. There is a possibility that Venus also had oceans as well, at some point in the past. So just in the solar system alone, we can see examples of other planets besides Earth that possibly had oceans of water on their surfaces. It is highly likely that the oceans formed on them and on Earth when comets or asteroids that contained water ice hit them in the past, creating huge portions of liquid water on the surface. Considering that we know that celestial bodies that contain water ice are relatively common, water in general is very common in the universe, and those objects also certainly get to hit surfaces of other celestial objects plenty of times, then that means that it is likely that planets with water oceans should be relatively common as well in other planetary systems. Even if it's just a 1 in 1,000 planet, that still means that there are 40 quintillion planets with water oceans on their surfaces in the observable universe. Out of these, their atmosphere could vary greatly. Such planets could mostly have in their atmospheres ammonia, carbon dioxide or other gases, and all sorts of other combinations. Now, the types of planets which have liquid water or maybe other liquids on their surfaces are also great candidates for having life forms. Now, the composition of our planet's atmosphere was dramatically altered because of life, specifically because of bacteria that can, through photosynthesis, produce oxygen. Around 2.5 billion years ago, such organisms appeared on Earth and filled the atmosphere with oxygen. Still, currently the atmosphere is around 78% nitrogen and 21% oxygen, so it is primarily nitrogen. But since such organisms are relatively pretty simple, and we can expect such life forms to exist on other planets, especially in the ones with liquid water on the surface, then there likely is a planet somewhere out there that also has huge amounts of oxygen, because of similar organisms, or maybe through some other methods, it could have also achieved such a great level of oxygen. So then there very likely is a planet composed of oxygen even at something like 40%, and is a lot thicker. It has an atmospheric pressure that is greater on its surface than the atmosphere on Earth. In that case, on such a planet, fires are started way more easily. Oxygen feeds fire. Then such a planet could also have surface gravity that is much greater than the gravity of Earth, even double. In the case of such a planet, if we say that the rest 60% of the atmosphere is something not deadly to breathe, like nitrogen, and the pressure is not too high, but just barely survivable, and the temperature is relatively not too high or low either, and the radiation levels are not too high, then you could be standing on the surface of that planet without dying immediately. And you would be able to breathe in that air that has way more oxygen, but it would be harder to breathe in an environment that has a higher atmospheric pressure, and that level of oxygen isn't really good at all for the body either. Plus, you would feel extremely heavy. You would feel 2 times heavier because it has around double the gravity of Earth. While walking on its surface, it would be like carrying around the weight of yourself on Earth. So although you could be there safely for some time, you wouldn't have a really comfortable time, although it would certainly be interesting to explore the oceans and the landscape of such an alien planet. Now, such a planet, that is the one with oceans of water, could also have wide rings. Then there likely is even a planet with oceans and a ring that has a moon that also has oceans on its surface as well. Maybe there is even a planet that has 2 such moons. Now, considering the number of planets with just oceans and some land too, there likely is even a planet that has a surface land shape currently that is very similar to the one currently present on Earth. Likely even a one with a blue atmosphere on top of that, like ours. That would be a twin Earth in that regard. Then there likely are even planets that are completely oceanic on the surface and have no land, and they also have a moon that is as well fully oceanic on the surface. Now, almost certainly there is a moon orbiting its gas giant planet at a great distance and away from other major moons that the gas giant has. That moon then would have a huge area that it gravitationally dominates, that can allow for it to have rings. That's right, there likely is out there a moon that has rings orbiting around a gas giant. Then there likely is a moon of some celestial body, likely a gas giant, that is far away from it and other major moons, and then that would allow it for it to have a moon itself, because of the huge hill sphere, again, the part around the moon that it gravitationally dominates. So there very likely is a moon with a moon, and sadly we can't really get as specific with the properties of a moon compared to the properties of just a regular moon and its planet, simply because it's likely an extremely rare occurrence. There are around 200 moons of planets in the solar system, yet not a single one has a moon of its own. So, although it is theoretically possible for the moon to have a moon, it's very likely a pretty rare thing. But still, considering the total number of moons, there likely is at least a spherical moon that has a spherical moon orbiting it. The rarity of a moon having a moon is likely similar to the rarity of a moon having rings. One of the very interesting moons in the solar system is Titan, a moon of Saturn. It has a thick atmosphere and huge lakes of liquid methane and ethane. Because of the distance to the sun that it is at, that causes it to be, on its surface, very cold. But that also allows for such lakes of methane and ethane in an atmosphere to exist. Otherwise, if it was as hot as it is on Earth, Titan would look very different. Now, we can expect a moon like Titan to be very rare. Somewhat surprisingly, likely more rare than a planet or even a moon with liquid water on the surface. Considering the huge number of moons in the solar system that have the potential to be like Titan, because they are in the zone where they could be, and yet still none of them are except Titan, that indicates that a Titan-like celestial object is a rarity. While oceans of water on the surface are, as we established, relatively common, they likely even existed in the solar system on planets besides Earth in the past. And there are currently in the solar system subsurface water oceans present on Europa, Enceladus, and likely many more celestial objects, as there are those indications. So a celestial object like Titan is very likely very rare. Still, there are almost certainly millions or billions of such objects in the observable universe. Many of them, unlike Titan, are likely just planets going around their star at a distance which creates a certain level of temperature which then allows for liquid methane and ethane to exist on their surfaces. Some are certainly even as big as Earth or even bigger, and a lot of them likely have atmospheres many times thicker. And unlike Titan, instead of just lakes, there could be oceans of liquid methane and ethane, covering a vastly bigger percentage of the surface than the lakes of Titan do on Titan. Pretty much, these are very alien, Titan-like worlds that do exist, and things can get even crazier. There likely is a planet or a moon that has a surface completely covered with liquid methane and ethane, an oceanic Titan, and of course, a Titan planet with a Titan moon. And then such Titan-like celestial objects could as well have wide rings. These planets possibly could even have some alien life forms that use liquid methane and ethane as a solvent, just like organisms on Earth use water as a solvent. Possibly some even relatively complex life forms evolve there that have such an alien chemistry. These Titan-like planets are truly a lot more alien to Earth than just planets with water oceans, and they are likely very alive places. They could have cryovolcanoes, have rains of methane and ethane, thunders, big mountains and canyons, and other interesting features. Now, besides Titan, there are certainly also plenty of Mars-like planets with a Mars-like moon, Venus-like planets with a Venus-like moon, and a gas giant planet with a gas giant moon, and all sorts of other combinations of traits. Then there almost certainly is also a planet with lava oceans, liquid rock. If a planet is close enough to its star, that could raise the temperature on the surface to the point at which rock would start to melt, which then can also allow for oceans of lava to be created. And likely there is a planet with lava oceans that has a moon that also has oceans of lava on its surface as well. So those are just some of the weird planets and moons that likely exist. Some of the ones that are mentioned here certainly exist, while with others, it is just highly likely, or just likely, that they do. The huge number of planets in the universe allows us to make predictions about the existence of such weird planets and moons. And because of probability, we can even get pretty specific with certain traits of these celestial objects and describe something that exists in the universe.